What's up guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to play Pokémon Unite on your Windows PC or Mac. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. To play Pokémon Unite on your PC, you must use an Android emulator such as BlueStacks. BlueStacks is a popular choice to play mobile games on your PC as it's optimized for playing mobile games. Click on the first link in the description to get to this page. From here, make sure to download the BlueStacks 5 setup installer to your system. This should only take a second to complete, and you can follow the install wizard to install the application to your system. After the installation is complete, BlueStacks should open up automatically. Next, open up your Play Store and ensure that you're logged in with your Google account. Search for Pokémon Unite and download the game to your BlueStacks emulator. This might take a few minutes to complete, depending on your network connection. While downloading the game, you should take a look at your emulator settings. Click on this gear icon to access these settings. In the Performance tab, you should set these according to your PC's performance. Allocate a high amount of CPU cores if you don't have a lot of other applications running in the background. The same goes for your memory allocation. For users with 4 GB or less RAM, set this option to low. Under Performance mode, make sure to set this option to balanced. This will reduce the memory and CPU usage if your PC lags or you otherwise encounter low performance. I prefer to enable the high FPS option and set the frame rate of the emulator according to my screen refresh rate. If unsure about your refresh rate, right-click your desktop and select Display Settings. From here, make sure that the correct display is selected, scroll down and click on Advanced Display. This will allow you to preview your refresh rate and change it if you want. Also, if you troubleshoot performance issues, make sure to enable the FPS counter option. In your display settings, set the display orientation to landscape and choose a fitting resolution to play Pokémon Unite on your monitor. You can also adjust the size of this window by dragging its corners. You can leave the other settings to the default option and play Pokémon Unite to see how well it runs on your PC. You will be required to download a patch after launching Pokémon Unite for the first time. You can then choose your preferred language and accept the terms of use before you can continue. Log in with your Google, Nintendo, or Facebook account to continue playing where you left off on your mobile device. Alternatively, you can choose to log in as a guest. Your final download will be the largest, which will take a couple of minutes to complete. While in-game, click on the keyboard icon in your BlueStacks menu bar on the right-hand side. This will allow you to enable and disable the on-screen controls option. This will help you figure out which keyboard keys to use to play Pokémon Unite on your PC. After completing the initial tutorial, navigate to your in-game settings. In your system settings, you can adjust the graphics quality to your system performance. It should be set to high or highest by default. But if you encounter any lag or performance issues, then I suggest lowering this option to medium. Below, set the frame rate option to high for a smoother gameplay experience. When this is done, head over to the control section of your settings. Here, you can adjust the lock on, automatic basic attacks, scoring controls, and so on. Your mouse and keyboard will work fine by default, but you might want to adjust some of these settings depending on your personal preference. If your controls end up wrong while in-game, then you can quickly reset all control settings back to default at the bottom of this page. If you want to prevent the game from downloading high-quality graphics and other data in the background, then head over to the Data Download section of your settings and disable the Allow Additional Data Downloads option. All of these settings and more information will be available in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.